For me, salt marshes are really special. They are an iconic part of the Essex coastline. Our salt marshes are eroding all around the country, and we need healthy salt marshes to provide all these amazing benefits. One of them, really importantly, to help us combat the climate crisis. My name's Rachel Langley. I'm the Living Seas Coordinator at Essex Wildlife Trust, and today we are at a site on the Colne Estuary in Essex. So a salt marsh is a key part of estuaries, and it is a changeable habitat that's regularly inundated by the tide and characterised by having these amazing salt tolerant plants. They can capture around 2 tonnes of carbon per hectare per year, and they can lock it into the sediment for centuries. When this sediment erodes, the carbon is released into the system and into the atmosphere. So our salt marsh restoration project started in 2018 as a collaboration between Essex Wildlife Trust and the Environment Agency, with the aims to restore eroding salt marsh and also protect our sea walls. The concept is simple enough, it's an experimental approach, and we're basically installing coir roll structures in selected salt marsh channels. The coir rolls are made out of a waste product from coconut, and they're basically, they're 3 metre long structures, 30 centimetre diameter. We affectionately call them salt marsh sausages. And the idea behind this is that sediment is accreting, and it's actually allowing vegetation to establish on the structures and the surrounding sediment. So here we've got one of our coir roll structures in position, and you can already see some of the vegetation establishing. So we've got the pioneer species such as salicornia, so these will be the first guys that colonise this lower muddy area. And we've also got the valcheria, which is the green algae that you can see on top, which paves the way for those pioneer species. So they do this by, as the seawall that we're standing on now, we've got this wonderful marsh fronting it, and it actually slows down the wave energy, dissipates that wave energy as it's approaching the shore, and means that the seawall is better protected. And as the salt marsh is eroding in many locations, it can be eroding from that lateral edge on the end and from within, it's meaning that its ability to dissipate that wave energy is lessening. So it's not only important for the habitat itself, but important for us to preserve these communities.
These are ecosystems that have been reclaimed throughout their history. Most of the area of the UK used to be a salt marsh in low energy environments, and they were reclaimed because they were thought to be worthless and should be turned into agricultural land. If sea level rise gets to greater than 7.1 millimetres per year, 9 times out of 10, the marshes will retreat.
As sea levels rise, the salt marshes would naturally want to migrate landward to keep up with that sea level rise, but these sea walls will prevent it. So over time, this can actually squeeze the area of the salt marsh, which is called coastal squeeze. And this is a big issue for these habitats and something that we need to take into consideration for future restoration and creation. So this is just one project. It's small scale at the moment, but we hope we'll be able to scale it up. But it's just one project. We need an approach across a range of habitats and a range of locations that are providing this with these amazing benefits and helping us combat the climate crisis. And it's important we're looking at different opportunities to do this across the board, promoting them, sharing learning, and getting the message out there about how important they are.